Hi everyone, this is Nick, and welcome back to our mini-series on how to make a visual infographic inside of PowerPoint. Thanks again to the Visual Capitalist over on Instagram, I'll link above and below to their post that will serve as the inspiration for this mini-series of videos here. Now this is the infographic that we're gonna end with. This is the sort of the remake that I made inside of PowerPoint. In our last lesson, we learned how to make this really nice visual graphic header. And in this video, we are going to learn how to insert a United States map onto our slide and make it a choropleth map or a heat map, because you can see that there are some areas of the map that are a little bit darker. Some of the states are a little bit darker than the other. So we're gonna go over here to our blank slide. I have the Visual Capitalist screenshot of their infographic there just for reference, because we might use some of the eyedropper tools and things like that to go ahead and pull some of the colors from. But I'm going to go ahead and escape from this slide, and this is what we're going to have to do to insert that map. PowerPoint is awesome because you can insert any chart type and it'll give you a template chart right away on your slide. So we're going to go to the Insert tab right here, go to the Chart menu, and we're going to go down to the Map function right here. Now, Excel and PowerPoint have this great filled map feature, so we're going to go ahead and click that map. We'll say OK, and then it will default to this world map right here on our slide. Now, I'm just going to move this over just so we can see it a little bit more. I might actually take the resizers and just kind of resize it just a little bit for our purposes. And I'm gonna get rid of the title because we don't need that title. Now here's the data source. You can see that it already pops up with this sort of template data for all these different countries. We only need the United States. So let's just go ahead and highlight all the other countries, push the delete key, and now you can see below that our United States map, it's responsive. It went right to the United States, but it doesn't have all the different state borders. So to do that, we need to insert the states that we want into this list. So I'm gonna drag this down, and I already have all of my states over here on a sheet here. So I want all of these states. I'm gonna do Control C to copy, and I'm going to paste them right here into our map. And now you can see that once we do that, it sort of gives, it sort of starts giving you a little bit of the picture. But right now, New York is only highlighted. And I think that's because you can see over here on our data source, we have this value set here. It's a number 8. It doesn't matter. You could put 1, 2, 3. You could put any number here. It doesn't matter the number. So I'm just going to make sure to fill this down with 8 the rest of the way. And once I do that, you'll see that all the states that we have highlighted there with those 8s are perfect. That's exactly what we want. So we're going to go ahead and close out the data source, and I'm going to go ahead and click on this series here, this little legend. We really don't need that. If I can actually click around, sometimes you got to click around to make things happen. You can also see that we have this little notation here, powered by Bing. Sorry, Bing, but I think we're going to get rid of that at some point, but I'm going to show you how to get rid of it, because you can't just click it and get rid of it there. But the first thing I want to do is I want the states to be the same color as my states over here in the screenshot of the infographic. So what I wanted to do here is click inside the map, just anywhere in the map, just make sure that you're clicking on the actual map. The Format Data Series menu pops up, and you can go right to the paint bucket. This is going to format, this is going to give you a general format for all of the states that are there. So right now it's set to automatic, but I'm going to go ahead and say solid fill. And I'm gonna do the paint bucket. Now, something that we notice is that the eyedropper tool is not available to us in the map feature. So in other features and other charts, we can use the eyedropper tool, or in other color picker situations, we can use that eyedropper tool, but we can't do it in a filled map. So if you wanted to, you could put on, you could add 2 shapes to your slide, just 2 squares, and go ahead and paint and fill those squares with the color that you want. And you can see in down here in my recent colors, I've already done that for this color right here. So I'm gonna say it's this tan color. I'm gonna keep that right there. If I wanted to update the outline of the border, I could also do that. We could say solid line. You can see it changes right there, but maybe I just want it to be this like really light tan color, and I think that looks really nice. Now I want these states, the California, New York, all those states that I want to highlight, to be a little bit darker. So to do that, we're going to use a different technique here. So with the map selected, we're going to go to the little under the Format Data Series menu, we'll go to the bar chart icon, and what we want to do is we want to go to the series color. Now this is telling us that you can have a sequential color from a very low value to a very high value. If you drop down this menu, you could also do a diverging color palette if you wanted to, if you wanted to have 3 different values, 3 distinct values there. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go ahead and set this maximum value. I'm gonna set the highest value to this very dark color that I've already included. And actually that color, I don't know if I like that too much, but the reason why the color looks a little bit blue and gray is because the lowest value is still defaulted to this really light blue. So in this case, I don't need a sliding scale. I just want those states to be the same color. So I'm gonna actually put the same color value for the high and the low. And now you can see that my states, the states that I want to highlight are actually highlighted. Perfect. Now this looks pretty good. Now, something that you might notice about the infographic is that the projection or the way the map is laid out is a little bit different than this map right here. So let's go back to that format data series menu and the bar chart menu right here. And let me show you this little drop down here under series options. It's called map projection. So it automatically gives you this Albers projection of a map. That's something that we're really used to seeing, I think, in the United States, that sort of upward curvature. But if you wanted to change the projection, we have a couple other projections here. You could do the Mercator, and I think that one is probably the one that Visual Capitalists used. You could also do the Miller, and that is even a little bit more flat and squished. So I'm actually going to go back to the Albers. I like that look and feel for the purposes of our infographic, and you can go ahead and update your projection to taste. So this is how we inserted that choropleth or heat map for the United States. I wanted to show you one other little trick here. We're going to get rid of that little annotation. And for the purposes of this tutorial, I'm just going to do something that will probably blow your mind. We're just going to go ahead and insert a little rectangle, and we're going to put it right over top of that shape. And I'm going to make sure that the rectangle is the exact same color as the background. We're going to go ahead and use that eyedropper tool. We're going to make sure that that is the same background as the background of the slide. Make sure that there's no outline there. And now you do not have those projections. Now you can also see this little note right here. If I click on it, it gives me a thing that says we've plotted 58% of the locations from your data with high confidence. So PowerPoint and Excel is going to give you that. I'm going to just eyeball it and make sure that we have all the states that we need in our data set here. And it looks like for the most part we do. So that's going to be pretty good. The other thing I noticed is that we also have Alaska and Hawaii. Now Alaska and Hawaii aren't included in our data. They weren't included in the infographic here. We might not need those states as well. So if we wanted to do that, we could go ahead and do that rectangle trick again too. I'm going to duplicate that box, and I'm just going to go ahead and put that rectangle. We're just going to manipulate the object, change the size of the object so that that works. You can, if you need more of a custom shape, we could also go ahead, right click, click on edit points, and then you can go ahead and just drag those points over the shapes that you want to sort of get rid of and kind of hide behind the scenes. So I'm just going to drag those, double click, and now you have a little custom shape right here, and you have that rectangle, and you have the map. If we wanted to group all of these things together, I could go ahead, select them all, push Control G and group them, and now they're just basically one shape. So a little graphic design trick there for you. There's another trick that we could actually cut this out, paste it in as an SVG, ungroup the whole thing, and then we could get rid of those text boxes and the Hawaii and Alaska. But for our purposes, we just want this on a nice slide. We're going to PDF it. We're going to put it on social media. I think that you can just do that little hiding trick, and your audience will be none the wiser, and you'll be good to go. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually PowerPoint, Excel, or Word. Make sure to go up and check out that mini series. Go ahead, go from the beginning and come right back. In our next lesson, we are going to work on putting some of the pins on the location pins on the cities on the map. So stay tuned for that, and I'll see you next time.